As you can see, we are at Sweetwater Brewing Company in Atlanta, Georgia.
And you're watching Mr. Liquid Bread!
Hey everybody, and welcome to the Mr. Liquid Bread Show, and I am your host, Mr. not Mrs. Liquid Bread. Tonight's show goes out to not only my brother and sister-in-law, but also friends of theirs and mine. They all of them went down to the great state of Florida, got me this little shirt right here, boom, at the World of Beer, including the beer that I'll be doing tonight that's boo right here behind me. So I thank not only my brother and sister-in-law, but also the Tuckers of the great state of Michigan for getting me this beer, giving y'all some rock. Boom! So those of you that aren't very familiar with the beer, craft beer industry, Florida's not typically a state you would associate with craft beer, but there is a great brewery out of there. There's probably several breweries out of Florida, but the one that I do associate with the great state of Florida is Cigar City out of Tampa Bay. Florida has apparently a pretty good history of craft beer. Florida Brewing Company was kind of the godfather of craft beer out of Florida before Prohibition. There's a great little write-up on Cigar City's website, which I'll put right down here in the bottom of the site, that details kind of how Florida evolved through craft beer before Prohibition, the Spanish-American War, through Prohibition, and after. So it's a really good little story. You should check it out if you got a few minutes to read about it. So Cigar City is most famous for two of their beers. One beer I'm going to do tonight. The other beer is celebrated every year on its release, which is the early part of March, right around that time. In fact, this year's celebration for this beer got all jacked up, and that is Hunapu, which is their, and I probably butchered that, I apologize, but that is their Imperial Stout. So since I said there were two famous beers by Cigar City, and Hunapu's was not the one I was going to do, if you know anything about Cigar City, then you know what the other one I'm going to do. And it is Alai IPA. And those of you that aren't familiar with Alai, Alai is a sport pretty much found in, I think, Florida in terms of the United States goes. I don't think any other states really have any Alai courts or anything like that. But Alai is a sport that you may remember from this TV show. Cool can. It reminds me of an orange juice can because of the orange, obviously. But if you look real closely at it or focus on it, you notice all the green are hop cones. So you know you got beer going on here. Probably the worst color font I've ever seen on orange, which is a orange yellow. Dudes, I can hardly read that. Come on. I'm old, but still, why don't you put a dark font on a lighter background? I mean, it's not that hard. So I'm kind of pissed about that. So on the back here it says, drink fresh, do not age, pour gently into a glass. And the glass that Cigar City recommends for this beer is a pint glass. It also says on here on the back kind of where they got the name, why they were using the name Alai. Alai, the merry game.
Hi, I'm Johnny Knoxville, this is Steve-O, this is Alai. Where'd that hit you?
Oh my God!
Is a game native to the Basque, B-A-S-Q-U-E, region of Spain. Tampa was once home to the high-speed game, but sadly, all that remains here is the India Pale Ale that we brewed in tribute to the merry game. Pair Alai India Pale Ale with empanadas, deviled crabs, and other spicy dishes. So this is a 7.5% ABV and 70 IBU beer. So pretty high ABV for just an IPA, in matter of speaking. And if you haven't noticed, this beer is in a can. This is the best container for beer, people. Best container. No light can get in this.
How'd you unite?
God, dude.
Whoa. No oxygen can get in this. And you know what? It sounds badass when you open it. You and I'm gonna use a pint glass. Let's just pour this bad boy in and let's see how High Lie tastes by Cigar City. Get a little head on this thing. Woo! Yeah! Ooh, I smell it already just from the side here. Got a nice two-finger head there. A little cloudy, a little hazy, I should say. Amber color, typical IPA color. Head's not holding solid at two, nice two fingers. Smells phenomenal though. Really good Citra aroma coming off of it. Maybe a little bit of caramel pininess. Oh. Let's drink. Wow. That's a good IPA, brothers and sisters. That is a good IPA. Woo! I was leery about this beer. I've heard a lot about it. You know, you get down south, a lot of those craft breweries, you know, it's hard to find them. You know, you got some Jester King down in Texas. You may want to get into some Sweetwater in Georgia. Albedo down in New Orleans. So, you know, Florida, Cigar City, I think you might have did something good here. The hop profile's got a good burn, if you will. This beer has got kind of a good balance between the two. It's got a little bit of that harshness, a little bitterness on the tip of my tongue. I've got a little bit of that burn. The middle and the sides of the tongue, I got a little bit of that caramel flavor. And then on the end of the swallow, the aftertaste, I get a little bit of that grapefruit, citrus, maybe a little bit of pininess at the end. Really, really good plethora or portfolio, or even if you want to call it potpourri of flavors in terms of the hop and malt balance there. Head's still holding pretty good there after drinking this down. I'm really impressed by that. This right here could be a lawnmower beer in the sense of you could drink this while mowing your lawn, but you probably wouldn't finish or you'd have a bunch of weeds in the middle because you just missed everything because you're drunk. Alright folks, let's get this beer down. You know I always slam it, so like a highlight ball at 200 miles an hour out of my curb, Mick. Let's slam it down. Cheers! Not a badly slammable beer. I like this beer. I like this beer a lot. Luckily, I got another one in the fridge. So once again, I want to give props to my brother and sister-in-law and my friends, the Tuckers, for hooking me up with the shirt. And the beer from Cigar City Brewing Company when they were in Florida. This is, again, High Lie IPA by Cigar City Brewing Company. This beer drinks pretty easily. It's got a great portfolio of hops coming down from anything from the grapefruit, citra, kind of almost like an orange zest almost, caramel flavors of the malts a little bit, all the way down to that piney, harsh, bittering resin on the tongue. Really great, great IPA. And it comes in a can. Best container ever, I've said that before, but the one thing I have a problem with, why are you putting a yellow font on an orange background? That's bullshit. I'm 43 and I can't read that shit. This is Mr. Liquor Bread, I'm out. Yeah. Not the can, the beer. Come on, Chris.